नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इक्विपोटेंशियल सरफेसेस। एन इक्विपोटेंशियल सरफेस इज दैट सरफेस एट एवरी पॉइंट ऑफ विच द इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल इज सेम। वी नो दैट द पोटेंशियल वी फॉर सिंगल चार्ज क्यू इज गिवन बाय वी इज इक्वल टू 1/4πε0 क्यू अपॉन आर। इफ आर इज कॉन्स्टेंट देन वी विल बी कॉन्स्टेंट, सो वी इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर। Hence, equipotential surface of single point charge are concentric spherical surfaces centered at the charge. For a line charge, the shape of equipotential surface is cylindrical. So you can see in this figure, okay, equipotential surface potential is the same from center point. Equipotential surface can be drawn through any region in which there is an electric field. By definition, the potential difference between two points P and Q is the work done per unit positive charge displaced from Q to P, so that it will be Vp minus Vq is equal to WQP. If points P and Q lie on equipotential surface, then Vp is equal to Vq, so that WQP is equal to zero. Okay, then work done will be zero. So it indicates that thus no work is required to move a test charge along the equipotential surface. If dx is small distance over the equipotential surface through which unit positive charge is carried, then work done is equal to E into dx. So E dot dx stands for E dx cos theta. We know that both are in same direction. So it will be 0, okay, cos 90 will be 0, okay. If they are perpendicular, then angle between them is 90 degree, so cos 90 will be 0. So E perpendicular dx, that is shown in figure 8.11, okay. So you can see here this figure. Hence electric field intensity E is always normal to the equipotential surface. For any charge distribution, the equipotential surface through a point is normal to the electric field at that point. If the field is not normal, then it would have a non-zero component along the surface. So to move a test charge against this component, work would have to be done. But by the definition of equipotential surfaces, there is no potential difference between any two points on any equipotential surface, and hence no work is required to displace the charge on the surface. Therefore, we can conclude that the electrostatic field must be normal to the equipotential surface at every point and vice versa. So there are 3-4 different surfaces are given. First we will see equipotential surface for a uniform electric field. Okay, so see here, okay, plates are arranged, potential is equal through all these three plates. Then equipotential surfaces for dipole, that is positive and negative charge. So lines are going out from positive charge and coming towards negative charge, okay, which are at equipotential. Then equipotential surfaces for two identical positive charges also, okay, again these are at equipotential. Then between two plates, metallic sheets are kept. So metallic sphere charged to a potential V, okay, that is also equipotential. So when one of the sheet is replaced by a charged metallic sphere, so like the lines of force, equipotential surface give a visual picture of both the direction and magnitude of electric field in region of a space. So these are the four points, okay, for a plate. Then it is for two poles, that is positive negative. Then it is for two like pole, okay, and then it is for a plane sheet also. Now we have to study electric potential, that is electric energy of two point charges and a dipole in an electrostatic field. So when two like charges lie infinite distance apart, their potential energy is zero, because no work has to be done in moving one charge at infinite distance from the other. But when they are brought closer to one another, work has to be done against the force of repulsion. So as electrostatic force is conservative, this work gets stored as the potential energy of two charges. Then electrostatic potential energy of a system of point charges is defined as the total amount of work done to assemble the system of charges by bringing them from infinity to their present location. So this is nothing but your electrostatic potential energy. So we will see it by using this diagram. Potential energy of a system of two point charges. So consider a system of two point charges, okay, x, y, z plane, okay. Point charge q1 at situated distance r1 at A, point charge q2 situated at distance r2 at B, okay, and distance between A and B is r12, okay. So we will show it by in the form of unit vector also. Now let us consider two charges q1 and q2 with positions vector r1 and r2 relative to some origin O. Now to calculate electric potential energy of two charge system, we assume that the two charges q1 and q2 are initially at infinity. We then determine the work done in bringing the charges to given location by an external agency. So by doing this process, okay, we can calculate the potential energy also. So in bringing the first charge q1 to position r1, no work is done because there is no external field against which work needs to be done, as charge q2 is still at infinity, that is work done is equal to zero. This charge produces a potential in a space given by V1 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 upon R1, where R1 is the distance of point A from the origin. Now, when we bring charge Q2 from infinity to R2, that is B, at distance R12 from Q1, work done is equal to Q into V, we know that. So, potential at B due to charge Q1 into charge Q2. Now q1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 upon r12 into q2, where AB is equal to r12, okay, that already we have shown in diagram. Now this work done in bringing two charges to their present location is stored as potential energy of configuration two charges, that is U is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 upon r12. So this equation can be generalized for a system of any number of charges you can write, okay. And similarly, we can write for n number of charges also, okay. So here we have this derivation, that is potential energy of a system of n point charges, okay. Now from equation 8.16, that is U equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon R12, okay, by using this equation, okay, we can use for n point charges. So by using this equation, okay, it is a expression for potential energy of a system of two charges. We now analyze the situation for a system of n point charges. In bringing a charge Q3 from infinity to C, that is R3, work has to be done against electrostatic forces between Q1 and Q2. So W3 is equal to work done potential at C due to Q1 and Q2 into Q3. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 upon R13 plus Q2 upon R23 into Q3. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q3 upon R13 plus Q2 Q3 upon R23. Similarly, in bringing a charge Q4 from infinity to at point D, R4, work has to be done against the electrostatic force between all remaining three charges Q1, Q2 and Q3. So this work done will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q4 upon R14, Q2 Q4 upon R24 and Q3 Q4 upon R34. Okay, and again two more terms, okay, that you can write here. So proceeding in the same way, we can write the electrostatic potential energy of a system of n point charges at r1 bar r2 bar up to rn as U equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 summation of all pairs qi, okay, so qj qk upon R JK. Okay, so this summation runs from JK values. Then we can see electrostatic potential energy of a single charge in external electric field. Okay, so that will be, above we have obtained an expression for potential energy of system of charges when source of the electric field charges and their locations were specified. Now in this section we determine the potential energy of a charge or charges in an external field E which is not produced by given charge or charges whose potential energy we wish to calculate. The external source could be known, unknown or unspecified, but what is known is the electric field E or the electrostatic potential V due to external sources. Here we assume that external field is not affected by charge Q, but if Q is very small, the external electric field E and corresponding external potential V may vary from point to point. So if V of R is the external potential at any point P having position vector r bar, then by definition work done in bringing unit positive charge from infinity to P is equal to the Q, okay, is equal to V value. So work done in bringing a charge Q from infinity to a given point in external field is QV of r bar. So work done is equal to Q into V, and this work done is stored in the form of potential energy of a system of charge Q. So since potential energy of system of single charge Q at r bar in an external field is given by potential energy is equal to QV of bar, okay, r bar we can consider now. Now potential energy of a system of two charges in external field. In order to find potential energy of a system of two charges Q1 and Q2 located at R1 and R2 respectively in an external field, we calculate the work done in bringing a charge Q1 from infinity to R1. Okay, and it is said that Q1 into V of R1 bar. So to bring the charge Q2 to R2, the work is done not only against the external field E, but also against the field due to Q1. Now, work done on charge Q2 against the external field, that is Q2 V2, okay, V of R2, then work done against Q2 will be Q1 is equal to, that is Q1 Q2 upon 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R12, where R12 is the distance between Q1 and Q2. By the principle of superposition, expression for the field, we add up work done Q2 against two fields. So work done in bringing Q2 to R2, so Q2 into V of R2 plus Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R12. So from this equation, potential energy of system, the total work done in assembling the configuration Q1 V1 plus Q2 V2 plus Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R12. So this is the total potential energy or total work done, okay, by assembling the charges. And now potential energy of a dipole in an external field. So this is uniform electric field we have considered here, okay, that couple acting on a dipole. Consider a dipole with charges minus Q and plus Q separated by a finite distance 2L and place in uniform electric field E. It experiences a torque which tends to rotate it. So torque is equal to vector P cross vector E, or torque is equal to P E sin theta. In order to neutralize this torque, let us assume an external torque, that is torque external is applied, which rotate it in the plane of the paper from theta 0 to theta without angular acceleration and at an infinitesimal angular speed. Work done by external torque will be, so theta 0 to theta, okay, we have to consider integration because it is continuously rotation. So torque of external of theta into d theta is equal to theta 0 to theta, okay, P E sin theta d theta. That also you can consider here. So we can calculate this integration where PE is constant. Okay, we can calculate only integration of only sin theta. What is integration of sin theta? It will be cos the minus cos theta. So minus cos theta and limits theta 0 to theta. So if you put limit, upper limit minus lower limit, that is minus cos theta of minus cos theta 0, then minus minus will become plus. So minus cos theta plus cos theta 0, then PE cos theta 0 minus cos theta. This work done is stored as the potential energy of the system in the position when dipole makes an angle theta with the electric field. The zero potential energy can be chosen as per convenience. So we can choose u of theta 0 is equal to 0. Therefore u of theta minus u of theta 0 is equal to PE cos of theta 0 minus cos theta. So there are again two conditions. Okay, if you want to see these two conditions, okay, first it will be if dipole is perpendicular to the field, okay, E bar, then theta will be, theta 0 will be what, pi by 2. Okay, so if you put here value pi by 2, so u of theta is equal to PE cos of pi by 2 minus cos theta. Okay, so we know that cos 90 will be 0. So it will be PE cos theta and into minus sign. So it will be minus PE cos theta. And we know that cos theta is nothing but your dot product. So U of theta is equal to minus P dot E. Okay. And if initially dipole is parallel to the field, E bar, then theta equal to 0. Okay. So if you want to see this dipole, okay, plus Q minus Q will be in same direction in the field, then this theta will be 0. So u of theta is equal to PE cos of 0 minus cos theta. So value of cos 0 will be 1. So it will be PE of 1 minus cos theta. So in this way you can calculate two cases, okay, when dipole is placed perpendicular and when dipole is placed parallel. Okay, when you keep perpendicular, your potential energy will be minus, that is minus P dot E. When it is parallel, then it will be plus P E 1 minus of cos theta. Okay, so in this way there are 4 to 5 points we have seen about potential energy of a dipole in an external field. Okay, so you can see here, this is dipole in an external field. Okay, then before that we have seen potential energy of system of two charges in an external field. Okay, before that potential energy of a single charge in an external field, potential energy of a system of 8 point charges, and potential energy of system of 2 point charges. Okay, so all these are the potential energies related about charges, related about potential energy with respect to electric field, okay, then with respect to its uniform electric field in terms of dipole also, then in terms of single charge, in terms of two charges also. So in this way we can study 5 points. Okay, so thank you students.